Good afternoon, dear students. So, today we will learn introduction to HTML. What is HTML? Before going to HTML, we will discuss some few things. You all are using the internet every day for using any information. If we want to search any information on the internet, then we have to use the website. Each and everything is available on the website, and that information is available in the form of web pages. So, what are the web pages? When you open any information on the internet, this particular page is opened, and that page is called as your web page. All the pages on the website are called web pages. All pages, each and every page on the website is called as web page. Now, how to design these web pages? We have to use the HTML. HTML is a language with the help of which we design the web page. Now, what is your HTML? I have just told you that HTML is used to design, to create the web pages. Now, what is the full form of HTML? HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. Hyper means links. We all have seen that when we are searching any information on the Google or on the internet, so many links are provided. We click on one link and another page will be open. So this is called as your hyper. Hyper means link. When we jump from one page to another page, it is called as your hyper or link. Now, text. Text means whatever the matter that is written on the web page is treated as your text. Markup language. Markup language means in HTML, to design the web pages, we have to use the text. If we want to decorate our web page, then we have to use the text. If we are not using the text, then our web page is not created. Let's learn how to create a web page in HTML. To create the web page in HTML, we need two things. First is your notepad, and the second one is your web browser. How to open the notepad? First, click on the start button, then click on the programs, then accessories, and then here comes a notepad. Your notepad will be opened. Here in this notepad, you will have to write the HTML code. And after this, we have to open the web browser, any web browser like yours, Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Opera, any web browser you can use to open your HTML page. Now, when you are done with the notepad work, you have to save your file with the extension .html. If you don't write the name followed by the HTML, it will not treat it as a web. It will treat it as a simple document. Suppose I have created this file. Now I will save it with abc.html. Now .html is compulsory to save the files if we are creating the web page. Now how to start the program in Notepad. First, each and everything that we write in HTML program is written in these two brackets. First, we have to write the HTML tag, and after this, we have to close the HTML tag. And to close any tag, we have to use the backslash. If we are not using it, then our tag will not close. First, we have to write the HTML tag, and after that, it has to be ended. Now, after this, here comes your head tag. And head tag, we can give the title. Title means, suppose this is your web page and this is your title bar. If we want to give the name on the title bar, then we have to use the title tag. Write the name and then we have to close the title tag. And then we have opened here the head tag. Then we have to close the head tag also. All these steps are compulsory. If we skip any tag, then our HTML program will not work. Next, the main part is your body tag. Whatever the thing we want to be displayed on our web page, that has to be written within the body tag. And after this, we have to close the body tag. And in between these body tags, we have to write each and every tag. Now, see. If I write P tag, P tag stands for paragraph. If we write anything, then it is displayed on the web page in the form of paragraph. So, each and everything that we write in HTML is written in the form of tags. If I don't use the brackets, our HTML program will not work. So, it works on the tags. Let's understand all these things practically.